guys, it's Emily.
And Grandpa John.
And welcome back to Country Double Play.
Woohoo! And thank you to our new subscriber. We're at 98. We're getting there.
Maybe by my birthday we'll make it.
Yeah, maybe. Or Christmas. We'll try New Year's. Sorry. We did get a nice comment from somebody the other day, and they said they couldn't understand why we didn't have more subscribers. So we'll just... We don't know either, but it is what it is. Okay, so what are we doing today?
Today we're going to be listening to Almost Persuaded by David Huston and...
Houston.
Sorry, couldn't see. And Tammy Wynette.
Okay, this is a really old classic. Well, not really old classic, but it is a classic. So
they're all old classics.
Yeah, let's get right into it. Okay, Almost Persuaded by David Houston and Tammy Wynette. Almost Persuaded is a song written by Glenn Sutton and Epic Records producer Billy Sherrill, and first recorded by David Houston in 1966. Almost Persuaded spent 9 weeks at number one on the Billboard Hot Country Singles chart starting in August 1966 and has since gone on to become a country standard. The song was also a moderate pop hit, reaching 24 on the Billboard Pop chart, and was David Houston's only top 40 entry into the pop charts. For 46 years and 2 months, no number one song matched the chart-topping longevity of Almost Persuaded until Taylor Swift's We Are Never Ever Getting Back Together Again notched its 9th week atop the Billboard Hot Country Songs charts the week of December 15th, 2012. The song won a Grammy Award for the Best Country and Western Recording of 1966. Tammy Wynette, who coincidentally recorded several duets with Houston, released her version in 1967. Okay, and I think we'll do David's version first.
Okie dokie.
Last night, all alone in a bar, met a girl with a drink in her hand. She had ruby red lips, cold black hair, and eyes that would tempt any man. Then she came and sat down. Sweet love made me stop and go home.
Okay, and now, Miss Tammy Wynette.
Last night, all alone in a bar, met a man with a drink in his hand. He had baby blue eyes, cold black hair, and a smile that a girl
Okay, one of Emily's favorite types, male, female version of the same song.
When I was reading the title and stuff, that didn't even cross my mind until we started listening to her, and I was like, oh, yeah. Yeah, no, I actually really liked both versions. I think, like how you said, it's my favorite type, how they kind of change it a little bit. For a male and a female perspective of the song.
Yeah, I like both. I don't have a preference. I think I grew up listening to David Houston's version, but
I really liked the message of it.
Yeah, so it's one of those funny songs where yeah, it's got a happy ending, but at the same token, why would you put yourself in that situation to begin with? You know. A lot of bad things happen because of stuff like that, but it turns out good. So that's, but like I said, you shouldn't put yourself in those places. So, but I like both versions. I could listen to either one. I was kind of a Tammy Wynette fan. I always liked her.
Her name sounds familiar.
Yeah, she did "Stand by Your Man." She did a lot of famous songs. She's actually she was another one passed before her time. And
I was gonna ask.
It's funny how many of them have. It's it was kind of sad. I was watching something the other day, and they were talking about, you know, Jim Reeves, how far he probably could have gone if he hadn't died, and what a great entertainer he really was. So a lot of these country artists, just passed away too soon. So anyway. Yeah, we're not really cutting a chart. I've got a radio interview to do in a little bit, so we got to get going. Kind of squeeze this in real quick. I got a lot to do tonight. It's a 4-day weekend coming up. Got stuff planned all weekend. So anyway,
what are you doing?
I'm going to the desert. Go shooting tomorrow.
With who?
Yeah.
Not our son.
Not our son. Yeah. Now we're gonna go out and.
Oh, I don't want to go.
It's funny. My wife says to me one day, she goes, God, how long are you guys going for? I said, the stuff we take, the only difference whether we go for a day or for a week is how much food we take with us. So it's the same amount of stuff if we want to do it the way we do it. So anyway, hey, a long weekend. I hope everybody gets a 3-dayer out of it. If you don't, sorry.
Woo-hoo.
Yeah, I get a 4-dayer thing. Yay.
This is my
working weekend.
Yep. I work the weekend and have the week off.
Yeah, she's going the other way. So, hey, oh, it's funny too. And actually kind of funny, interesting, when I said last week, try to be happy or choose to be happy, my horoscope said something right along those lines. Says,
you
make
read
sure
your horoscope?
You, oh, every week, every day.
Really?
Yeah. Sometimes it's interesting. Mine said, you have a chance to make people happy.
Oh, my God.
It was kind of funny. I think I read it that night, so, or the next day. So, anyway. So
words of wisdom.
Yeah, words of wisdom. See,
brought down to you from the universe.
The planets brought you my message. Okay, guys. You all have a good one. Have a safe weekend if you're traveling.
I almost said love you.
Yeah. Have a safe weekend if you're traveling, because it is a crazy weekend. And
be safe. Don't drink and drive or anything.
And we'll see you next week with another classic country. Okay. We got a little issue, but so maybe Friday or Saturday. If not,
tomorrow. or actually.
Oh, I thought you meant next Friday or Saturday.
Oh, well, that actually. We'll talk about it.
Okay.
We'll talk.
Not a problem. Well, if we don't
you'll
have
see
one,
us.
Yes. If we don't have one next week, you'll know why. Nothing bad happened. Anyway, you guys all have a good one, and we'll see you next week. Bye.
Peace out, Girl Scouts. Catch us on the radio.
Bye.